Welcome to Windows Virtual Desktop Essentials. If your organization is looking for a more efficient, productive, and secure approach to desktop virtualization, in the next few minutes, I'm going to walk you through Microsoft's Windows Virtual Desktop solution on Microsoft Azure. It offers a fully managed desktop virtualization solution in the cloud. And the good news is it works with all your apps and devices. As you can expect, we have full-featured native client support for Windows, Mac, iOS, and Android, as well as new HTML5 support so that you can access remote desktops and apps from almost any modern browser. So why desktop virtualization? Well, for a while, it's been looked upon as a solution for enabling central management security of your users' desktops and also with less IT management overhead. Now, this approach separates your operating systems, data, and apps from local hardware, running them instead separately on a remote server. Now, the main appeal is that you can separate the compute environment from user devices so that the risk of confidential information being left on a personal device is greatly reduced. You can also make sure that your virtual machines run in close proximity to apps and services that connect to your data center or the cloud. End users have the freedom to connect with any device over the internet, and for IT, you don't have to worry as much about the device that's connecting so long as the network connection is secure. That said, standing up a desktop virtualization environment has traditionally been expensive and also complex. Users have often lacked the productivity experience of a locally provisioned desktop, and it can take weeks and sometimes months to get a successful implementation up and running. Now, with Windows Virtual Desktop, all of this complexity goes away. We give you a remote desktop infrastructure that contains the roles that you would have had to manage at scale. Things like your gateway, broker, diagnostics, load balancing, and more as a fully managed service on Azure. All your VMs in the Windows Virtual Desktop service communicate over a secure outbound connection, and you benefit from unlimited capacity. And you can also choose any size VM in Azure and vary the density of users based on the workload. We also give you more choice in how you distribute users across those VMs. For example, you're not limited to a Windows Server OS in cases where you want to assign more than one user per virtual machine. With Windows 10 Enterprise Multi-Session, for example, you can gain efficiencies by having multiple users on a single VM, and unlike multi-session Windows Server implementations, it has a support for modern apps like OneNote and Office 365 apps, and we're going to talk more about that in a minute. Importantly, you still have full control over VHD images, and you can use pre-built images in Azure or bring your own custom images. You can deploy a full desktop, remote apps, or both, and of course, you can scale up or scale down as needed while paying only for what you use. Now, for users, things get even better. Now, there's no compromise between their virtual desktop productivity experience and what they would experience if they had a locally hosted desktop running on their PC. It's the same. Now, in Windows 10, for example, your full collection of apps, whether they're Win32 line of business apps or UWP apps, those will run. Apps are fully integrated with the start menu. You can pin them to your taskbar, and the only indication the app is virtual is through the glyph. You can copy, paste, or snap apps side to side. They look and feel like local apps. And you don't even need to be on a PC. You can also be on a Mac, iPad, iPhone, your Android phone, or even the browser. The experience is going to be the same. What's more, the integration with FSLogic's technology and Windows Virtual Desktop makes the experience of working with stateful apps painless. Now, for example, you can fire up Outlook and be productive right away without waiting for the mailbox to populate. Now, this is because as a user, your profile data is containerized in a separate virtual disk, and that's going to attach in real time to any session on any VM right as you log in. So it feels like your inbox and all your local files are persistent as if they're running from the local C drive. Now, OneDrive files on demand also benefit from FSLogic's. Users have full access to their files stored in OneDrive and File Explorer, so their on-demand files are always available and launch right away. Behind the scenes, the OneDrive Sync client and Windows 10 Enterprise Multi-Session work together to support OneDrive files on demand. WVD utilizes the default 1 terabyte storage that users have as part of their Office 365 subscription to let OneDrive cache their most recently accessed files. Now, this means that when a user selects an on-demand file, it immediately hydrates using the high-speed network and infrastructure across the Microsoft cloud to ensure that files move as fast as possible to become locally available. And of course, you can ensure that data never lives on the consuming device by configuring information protection controls, and you also have complete auditability of your environment. That said, identity is the cornerstone of the user experience and also protecting your data. Azure Active Directory or Azure AD unlocks a secure, consistent sign-on experience for users with the ability to roam from device to device. And it ensures that only the right people have access to apps and data. You can also configure multi-factor authentication. This lets you take advantage of conditional access controls that determine access based on who you are, your device, the types of apps you're accessing, and your location. Now, Windows Virtual Desktop even supports passwordless authentication approaches, including biometrics, such as with Windows Hello. Now, beyond user authentication, Azure AD also allows you to manage admin privileges with role-based access controls that govern your Azure resources. If you're already using Azure or using Office 365 or any other Microsoft services, you already have an Azure AD. If not, there are numerous options available to sync Azure AD with your organization's directory service. You can learn more about this in the preparation episode coming up on Microsoft Mechanics. Now, you can manage WVD from within the Azure portal along with all your other Azure services. And there are a few additional areas where Windows Virtual Desktop really helped drive operational efficiencies for your virtual desktop environment. As I mentioned before, you can assign multiple users to a single VM using a client OS, not a server OS. Now, Windows Virtual Desktop uniquely breaks away from the one user per VM model of the past for client operating systems to deliver the only Windows 10 multi-session experience. Now, this is still supported, but increases your overhead. So for example, in a one VM per user model, you typically size each of the user's VMs based on anticipated peak usage. But in typical work days, a task or an office worker will rarely consume peak capacity of that VM. Now, with a multi-user model, you can deploy a single VM with sufficient CPUs and RAM to host several users on a single virtual machine. Now, this reduces your resource requirements significantly while providing a great user experience. Next, as I mentioned earlier, you can assign collections of VMs, which we call host pools, to specific users. Now, this could be by department. And what that means is if one department needs VMs with more horsepower, such as your creative design team, that might require fast GPUs, you can select the right VMs for their needs. Now, we also give you the options to load balance users on your virtual machine host pools. So for best performance, you can configure breadth mode. Now, that evenly allocates your users across the host pool for your workload. And if you want to optimize for cost savings, you can configure your VMs for depth mode load balancing. And in this mode, the load balancer fully allocates users on a single VM before moving to the next one. And with our scaling tools, you can automate provisioning of additional VMs as needed once a specified threshold is met to support incoming demand. And we also have pre-built Azure Resource Manager templates available to create and update your host pools consistently. That said, though, one of the biggest areas where you can reduce your overall running costs is with storage. Using OneDrive available in virtualized scenarios, it's possible to have terabytes of files per user in an Office 365 service and to not incur additional storage costs. Now, the combination of the virtual machine infrastructure hosted in Microsoft's cloud and the connection to unlimited OneDrive storage is both fast and bottomless. Now, this enables you to also provision smaller virtual machines and storage footprints per user to save costs while still providing best-in-class file access performance. And with the addition of Azure Files, you can centralize your organization's file shares in Azure using Azure File Sync. This can be used to sync and migrate on-premises file share data to Azure and accelerate access to content from your WVD session hosts. Finally, the separation of user profiles from virtual machines using FS Logix helps reduce your overall data storage footprint and costs without compromising performance or app compatibility. So that was a quick overview of Windows Virtual Desktop on Microsoft Azure. This allows you to take a secure and efficient approach to centrally managing your PC and device estate without compromising your user productivity inside your organization. What's more, if you still need to run Windows 7 desktops, WVD offers the unique advantage of allowing you to run them in the cloud for up to 3 years without having to pay for extended security updates, all past the January 14th, 2020 end of support date. You can also migrate your existing RDS deployments and use your existing licensing to bring those environments to WVD. So next, please continue to watch our series for hands-on guidance on the steps to prepare, deploy, and optimize Windows Virtual Desktop for your organization. Thanks for watching.